What's going on, guys? It's Greg from Kinobody Fitness Systems, and today I'm going to take you through workout A of the Get Sliced and Get Shredded in 6 weeks program. Now, the key here is to remember, we're trying to get lean and shredded. Alright, so we don't have to do as much strength training as normal because all we're trying to do is hold on to our muscle. We're trying to maintain. Now, most people make the mistake when they're cutting of doing way too much training volume. And because they're eating less, because in order to lose weight, you gotta eat less calories, they aren't able to rebuild the muscle. They're tearing it down and they don't have enough to rebuild. So, what we're doing is we're doing just enough strength training to hold on to our muscle. And that's usually about 1/3 to 1/2 of your normal training volume. Now, we're refilling that extra space with core training, with a focus on straightening those transversal abdominals to get that lean, hard, strong midsection. And we're filling it with lots of fat-burning cardio, because that's going to bring us to the goal the fastest. If we train to be big, it's going to be a hard time cutting. But if we train to be lean and fit and strong, you're going to have a much easier time. Now, the first exercise we're going to do of workout A is the incline dumbbell bench press. This is one of my favorite exercises because it develops the pecs very nicely. It really focuses on the upper pectoral region, which is really important for having masculine pecs. Now, we're only going to do 3 work sets here because, again, we don't want to overtrain. We just want to activate the muscle to tell our body to hold on to it, but not to break it down. And we're going to focus on the 4 to 6 rep range. This is the best rep range, in my opinion, for building hard, dense muscle. Because when you train the higher rep range, like bodybuilders do, 8 to 12 reps with short rest periods, you're really targeting sarcoplasmic hypertrophy, which is an increase of the fluid-like substance in the muscle, which gives your muscles the pump and the bulky feel to it. But when you train with lower rep ranges, you develop strength and you develop myofibular hypertrophy, which actually increases the size and density of your muscle fibers, which leads to a stronger and slightly bigger muscle. So this is the best rep range to use when cutting. And in addition, it's very effective to use when cutting because you actually maintain your strength. When you cut down those 10 pounds, you're gonna be just as strong as you were before, or if not stronger. And when you use those high reps when you're cutting, you're actually gonna make things a lot worse because in those high rep ranges, you're breaking down your muscles. You're causing your muscles to deplete their glycogen stores. And when you're depleted, your body's gonna have those carb cravings. But when you train in the lower rep range, that does not happen. So for the exercise, you're gonna pick your dumbbells up, place them on your knees, and you're gonna lift your knees up to bring it right down back into position. Now here, we want to focus on the shoulders back, chest arched, we want to press it up. 1. Breathe in on the way down. Exhale on the way up. 2. Breathe in. Up. 3. You don't have to fully extend your arms, but you want to get a little bit close. 4. And one thing you don't want to do is bang dumbbells together. This does nothing. It actually takes the tension off your chest. 2 more. 5. Good. Last one. Bring it down, squeeze the chest, and explode up. All right, so after you finished your first set, you're gonna take about 2 minutes rest between sets. 2 minutes is a good amount of rest time to lift heavy weights. Because when you take short rest periods, your strength goes down and you can't lift the same weights. And besides, the strength training is solely focused on maintaining muscle and strength. So we're not going for endurance here. We're not going for calories burned. We're doing that at the end of our workout. So that's why we take 2 minutes rest. So the next exercise we're gonna do is for biceps, and it's the incline dumbbell curls. This is a great one. It really getting a nice stretch in your biceps, getting a full range of motion, because when you're leaned back on the incline bench, you allow yourself for gravity to kick in a lot later. So you're gonna get your dumbbells, you're gonna sit back, get a nice stretch of those arms, and you're gonna curl it out to the side. This hits the inner bicep really well. We're gonna alternate, get a full stretch. 1. Good. You count every other rep. 2. And 2. 3. And 3. Squeeze at the top. 4. Very strict. 4. We're gonna do 1 more. 5. And 5. For these curls, you wanna control on the way up and control on the way down. All right, so we're only doing 2 strength exercises per workout. So now we're gonna move on to abs. Now for this workout, we're gonna start off with the plank. The plank is a great exercise. It's strengthening your transverse abdominals. and that's your deep inner abs. The transverse abdominals is very pivotal for core stability. In addition to that, it acts as your inner weightlifting belt, in that it keeps your waistline nice and tight and slim. So you sometimes you see bodybuilders or people with a bloated gut like this. Well, by strengthening your TVA, you're able to pull that stomach in naturally. Now, for the plank, a lot of people do this exercise incorrectly. You're gonna give your forearms and your feet like this, and you're gonna maintain strong core positioning. You wanna think of sucking your belly button up into your spine. This really activates the TVA. In addition to that, you don't wanna sag that back. A lot of people do the plank like this. It's actually terrible for you. So make sure you keep that strong TVA, flat back, pull the belly button, and activate those abs. So, that's the beginner plank, and that's where everyone should start. For this workout, we're gonna do 5 minutes of plank. So you're gonna do the plank for 5 minutes and take as much rest as you need in between. I recommend starting with 30-second plank, 30-second rest, complete 5 times for 5 minutes. As you get stronger, you can do 40-second plank, 20-second rest. And once that becomes easy, you wanna move on to the next plank variation. All right, so for the superstars out there, I got a great variation that really makes the plank a lot more challenging. And the variation consists of using a stability ball. So, the normal plank is with your forearms on the ground. This time we're gonna put our forearms up on the ball. This actually makes it about 30% harder. So now you gotta stabilize and it really kicks in. It's much more difficult. You wanna make it harder? Move your forearms out further. This makes it extremely challenging. And once that gets easy, you can actually raise your feet up onto a bench so that the bench is the same level with the ball. And at that point, you're really gonna be building some super strong abs. All right, guys, we got one more ab exercise to complete, and that's the swinging side-to-side bent knee ups. This one is great at really bringing out those lower abs that are super difficult to get, you know. Everyone, if they drop a little bit of body fat, boom, they got the upper abs, but it's not the same case with the lower abs. In addition to working those lower abs, it's also gonna focus on that V cup. The definition right here that the girls just go nuts for. So every guy, you gotta hit up this exercise. All right, so, we're head from the bar, like so, and we're gonna try and get as many reps as you can get here. We're doing 2 sets, as many as you can. So, start here, you're gonna go all to the side, switch other side, back and forth. We're not bringing those knees all the way down, we want constant tension. Boy, do I ever feel that right there. Whew. Guys, this one is one of the best ab exercises I know. Now, in conclusion, that's part one of workout A. So, we did some strength training. We hit incline dumbbell bench, 3 sets of 4 to 6, 2 minutes rest. We then hit incline dumbbell curls, again, 3 sets, 4 to 6 reps, about 2 minutes rest in between. And then we hit some abs. We're doing the plank for 5 minutes with a little bit of rest in between here and there. If you're advanced, you're doing a stability ball. After that, we're doing 2 burnout sets of the swinging side to side bent knee raises. Now, once you finish that, it should take you, you know, around 30 minutes to do that, maybe less. Once you finish that, now we're doing interval training. Interval training or circuit training. So what interval training is gonna do, it's gonna boost up your body's fat burning hormones. All right, it's gonna boost up those HGH. Now HGH is gonna force your body to release all those stored fat cells into your bloodstream. So now you're in a fat burning zone. So we're only gonna do 10 to 12 minutes of high intensity interval training because that's all it takes. After we do that, we're gonna follow that up with easy steady state cardio just to burn off those free fatty acids. Now, you don't have to do interval training. Interval training is one option. The other option is to do circuit training, where you get you know, 4 or 5 exercises in a row that work your whole body, and just go right through them, rest a little bit, do it again. That has the same effect.